Hello friends, welcome to QuestQuant. With the post-monsoon cyclone season underway for the Indian coastline, especially the east coast of India, our team decided to bring to you the dynamical aspects of a tropical cyclone. Cyclones are a rapidly rotating mass of dry and moist air. They are massive, tall, spiral clusters of thunderstorms that have a well-defined low-pressure center and a closed atmospheric circulation with strong vorticity. Many factors play a role in the genesis of a cyclone, given by something known as the Genesis Potential Index. The primary Genesis Potential Indices are: number 1, sea surface temperature, which should be greater than 27 degrees Celsius to favor a cyclone formation. The second one is the ocean heat content, which is defined as the thermal energy present in the top 1000 meters of the ocean. It is usually denoted in kilojoules per centimeter square, and a value of around 100 kilojoules per centimeter square is highly favorable for a cyclone formation. Then we have the wind shear, which is defined as the difference in the wind speeds between 200 millibar and 850 millibar levels. Ideally speaking, this should be less than 10 knots so that the system can organize. Finally, we have the Coriolis effect, which allows the system to rotate and the atmospheric circulation pattern can form a closed loop. Now, apart from these four indices, there are two more very important secondary genesis indices which usually play a wild card in the cyclone intensification and track. They are the Madden-Julian oscillation and atmospheric waves. The Madden-Julian oscillation is the largest intra-seasonal variability in the atmosphere that occurs as a result of air-sea coupling. It is seen as a unidirectional wave moving very close to the equator from west to east and thereby covering different parts of the globe. As it moves into different tropical oceans, it brings along a strong convective activity in that ocean with a high probability of a cyclonic system. The MJO phase plot gives a clear picture on how strong the signal is and in which ocean is it situated. The MJO activity strongly depends on the movement of oceanic Rossby and Kelvin waves. Next up, we have the atmospheric waves, such as the inertial gravity waves, the mixed Rossby gravity waves, or convectively coupled Kelvin waves. All these waves are atmospheric waves, and these aid in propagation of a perturbation from one place to another, thereby triggering strong instabilities between the upper and lower levels of the atmosphere. What it does is, it lays the platform for a strong coupling with the ocean and exchange of moisture. The perturbations also aid in deposition of vorticity, which is very crucial for strong systems like cyclones or hurricanes. Therefore, the role of MJO and atmospheric waves is very important for cyclone genesis and intensification. Next, we want to talk about the movement of a cyclone, which is controlled by the MJO, which is the Madden-Julian oscillation, and upper level ridge action. The ridges are nothing but high pressure zones at upper levels, typically seen at 200 millibar or 300 millibar level. All the cyclones tend to move along the ridge. India is surrounded by two ridges, the Indo-Arabian ridge towards the west and the Indo-Pacific ridge towards the east. The presence of MJO can also modulate the ridge action, and thereby it plays a very important role in governing the cyclone track. Now, once a cyclone forms, it has three distinct features, which are the eye, the eye wall, and the rain bands. The eye is the central portion of a cyclone where the pressure is the lowest. This is the part where the convection starts and moisture is pulled in from outside. The moisture is pushed vertically upwards, leading to formation of gigantic clouds. However, the eye of the cyclone is clear of any clouds since cold air from upper levels descends down from the eye of the cyclone. This allows us to see the eye distinctly in the satellite images. Next up is the eye wall, which is the most dangerous part of a cyclone because it packs strong winds and very heavy rains. The convection is strongest in the eye wall. The more compact the eye wall, the more dangerous the storm, and this particular aspect could be easily understood from the conservation of angular momentum. An ice skater spins faster when she brings her arms in, giving her very high angular velocity. The same concept is applicable to the eyeball of a cyclone. The outermost part of the cyclone is called the rain bands, which are somewhat disorganized and they bring moderate rains and moderate winds. We would like to conclude by saying that the sea surface temperature is not the only factor that governs a cyclone, since many media articles only highlight this particular parameter. There is a very common misconception that if the sea surface temperature is high, a cyclone will form. If that is indeed the case, the tropical Indian Ocean is always at an elevated state, reporting temperatures greater than 29 degrees Celsius. So the immediate question is, why do we not see cyclones every day? The answer lies in the fact that the other genesis potential indices like the ocean heat content, the wind shear, the Madden-Julian oscillation and atmospheric waves, all of these factors have to come together to give you what we call a cyclone. We hope you all enjoyed watching this video. Please share it with your family and friends, subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon for instant notification and exciting updates. You can also express your views and suggestions in the comment section. Thank you.